Let's now talk to House Deputy Speaker Dan Fernandez. He's one of the lawmakers who voted to reject Cayetano's offer of resignation as House Speaker. He also signed a manifesto expressing support for Cayetano's continued leadership. Good morning, Congressman Fernandez, and thank you very much for joining us this morning, sir.
Good morning, Christian, and thank you also for inviting the offer.
So is it over for Congressman Lord Alan Velasco, and is the term-sharing deal effectively scrapped with what happened yesterday?
Yes, I think the term-sharing agreement was already consummated. And the offer of resignation of the Speaker was rejected by the majority of the House members. And we have already spoken, and the President, through his spokesperson, Harry Roque, have already said that the President will not longer interfere with the decision of the House.
Well, what do you mean the term-sharing agreement was already consummated when, in fact, it was not? It wasn't followed in the first place because of the of what happened yesterday.
Well, Christian, you know the actual detail of the what happened meeting with the President together with Alan Velasco and Speaker Alan Cayetano. Wala naman actually na talaga October 14 that the President, the Speaker will resign. It was not really agreed upon kung ano pa talaga yung date na magre-resign na si Speaker. As a matter of fact, si Speaker Alan Cayetano, in his privileged speech, he narrated what happened doon sa usapan with the Speaker, with the President. And he said that anytime he can resign. If the President tells him that he resigned now, he will. As a matter of fact, the Speaker also narrated to us through his privileged speech, if the President asks him to resign as a congressman, he will. Hindi naman natin nakita during the term of Speaker Alan Cayetano na sa 14 months that he said that he will not follow the gentleman's agreement. As a matter of fact, he agreed. And ito nga yung wish ni Congressman Alan Velasco that he resigned on September 30. And what the Speaker did was, he resigned yesterday. But unfortunately, ang hindi nakita ni Lord Velasco ay merong 300 members of Congress. We are a collegiate body, Christian. You have to remember this. And each and every member of the House have the right to vote and to choose his own leader. And that's what we did. We respect the decision of the President to somehow try to negotiate a term-sharing agreement. But the other members of the House, we are not bound by that agreement. The problem with Congressman Alan Velasco, he never reached out to each member of the House. Unlike si Speaker Cayetano, when he was voted to be the Speaker of the 15-month term sharing, he reached out to each and every one of us. That's the reason why when he delivered this message or this privilege speech yesterday, marami ang nag-reject nitong kanyang offer to resign. Precisely because we are a working team right now.
Okay.
And
now,
the group of Alan Velasco never initiated to approach the leadership of the House.
Okay, I'd like to clarify the action taken by Speaker Cayetano yesterday. He offered to resign, but did he actually resign? What's the difference?
Well, he offered to resign. He put it into body. At sinabi niya that he did his best and he don't want to be the part of the approval of the budget anymore because of this black propaganda that the other group is doing right now. They have agreed with the President. Ano, sa narration niya, sinabi niya that the President even insisted four times, Christian. The President asked Alan, Lord Velasco, to give way till December, after the approval of the budget. But Lord Alan Velasco insisted that September 30 is the last day of Speaker Alan Cayetano. At wala pa naman actual na talagang date na magre-resign si Speaker. But okay, the Speaker didn't try because he felt that he was offended. But what they did, not only that they insinuate that there is already an October 14 deadline, and Lord Alan Velasco was insinuating also and trying to tell the members of the House of Representatives that he wanted it on October 14. Pero doon nga sa pakiusap ni Presidente, hindi niya pinagbigyan si Presidente. And it was felt by the Speaker para na lang walang gulo because he followed the President, he offered to resign. And
okay,
he did that.
Okay.
But
you just like
the vote of the majority of the House of Representatives matters, Christian.
Okay, of course, that's true. The vote of the actual members of the House matters. But in the first place, if Speaker Cayetano wanted to follow strictly the term-sharing agreement that he had with the president, as brokered by the president, with Congressman Velasco, why didn't he just resign, actually, not just offer to resign, or have the seat declared vacant?
Well, they can do that anytime. Other members of the House can do that. As a matter of fact, Christian, any member of the House of Representatives can declare the speakership vacant.
Of
and
course.
They will do that. And they will attempt that. And they did that already. As a matter of fact, Christian, no? They attempted to have a coup twice already. No? And palagay ko, they will try to attempt to do this again and again. And as long as you have numbers, no, Christian, you will be able to get it. But the problem is with these people, no, with this group, ang problem nila, they never approach the other members. Eh. Even yung mga kasamahan na nila mismo sa PDP Laban, they are saying that hindi sila binibigyan ng pagkakataon na makausap ni Congressman Alan Velasco.
So are you saying that the Congressman Velasco only has himself to blame for failing to clinch the speakership?
Well, alam mo, Christian, no? The speaker have delivered a touching message yesterday, and their accusation is that this is staged or scripted, no? Pero I think hindi eh. Yung approach ni Speaker Alan Cayetano on reaching out on each and every member of the House of Representatives, it resulted in a positive way by supporting him all the way. There's nobody to blame him but himself. Alam mo, Christian, if I myself is a presumptive speaker already, no, and I being attacked in the floor like yesterday, I should have stand, no, I should have defended myself yesterday. Kung nung nagsasalita si Speaker Alan Cayetano for almost 1 hour, there is a chance for him to say what really happened, no, and defend himself. But unfortunately, he wasn't able to do that. Eh.
Was he there in the first place? Was he present on the floor?
Who?
Congressman Velasco, was he there on the floor?
I assume he was in the Zoom, no? And he should be. He is the presumptive speaker. And the problem nga dito, Christian, no? For so many months that we were being working together, no? As a group, in order to make the house looks good in the eyes of the people and to deliver the a lot of problems that are being encountered by our countrymen. But the problem is hindi nga po namin siya nakakasama. He never approached us. He never worked with us. With all the measures that we have approved, that was set by the Executive Department, the Bayanihan 1, Bayanihan 2, the different investigation that we conducted, he was never there. Kaya I assume wala rin siya kahapon sa Zoom, kaya siguro hindi siya nakapag-interpelate at hindi man yan man lang napindepensa ang kanya sarili. That's a problem with him, eh. Mm. Okay, so it's not our fault kung nangyari sa kanya to. It is fault.
Was this a case of Congressman Alan Peter Cayetano also outwitting or outmaneuvering his competitor?
Well, it's not outmaneuvering, eh. Ano? Christian, I would say that this is the voice of the majority of the House of Representatives. We have best spoken. We have delivered our message that Speaker Cayetano should stay. We don't want him to resign. And that's the question that we addressed yesterday. Now, anytime they can ask for a change of the leadership.
Okay.
They have the numbers.
It's quite curious that you're citing the voice of the members of the House. But of course, we know in reality, we've also spoken with some of your colleagues and they admitted that the president's word carries a lot of weight when it comes to decisions by the House of Representatives, as we saw last year when Speaker Alan Peter Cayetano assumed that particular position. So is it this an invocation of congressional independence whenever convenient?
Well, actually, the agreement between the two gentlemen, we are not bound by it. It is a gentleman's agreement between them. We respect that, and we respect that the president also interfere with this. But the problem is, you have to reach out with the members. It's not automatic, ano, Christian, nakapag-agree na sila, you have to put that in the floor. Eh. There is a process. Eh. And remember, during that time that the speaker, that the president have brokered that agreement, no? Si Speaker Alan Cayetano, he reached out with all the members. He met all the members, each and every one of them. And then we voted. And then he got 248 votes, if I'm not mistaken. But dito po, si Lord Alan Velasco only relied on the endorsement and on the term sharing agreement. He never approached or never reached out to all of us.
But
and that's really matters.
Okay, of course that's true.
Dito, there's nobody to blame but himself.
Okay.
He himself done is to be with us for the last 15 months. Siguro nagkaiba ang resulta. Siguro nagkaroon ng smooth transition. Siguro hindi na umabot na ang presidente have to interfere and broker the gentleman's agreement again. Siguro okay. Si Speaker Alan Cayetano o Lord Velasco, dahil okay naman tayo, ito na, pagpapatuloy mo lahat ng ginagawa natin, ito na, binibigay ko na sa iyo. As a matter of fact, that was the purpose of Speaker Alan Cayetano. He was about to give it up to Lord Velasco. But unfortunately, they, aside from spreading fake news, they insinuated that there is an agreement on October 14.
Okay.
But in reality, in truth and in fact, there was none.
Okay.
Kaya nga nung sinabi ni Speaker ni Alan Velasco that your term expired on September 13 and you should have resigned in front of the president, Speaker Alan Cayetano did that. He resigned September 13 and okay. That was yesterday.
Now, so basically that was the fault, quote-unquote, of Congressman Velasco. But in terms of relying on the president's endorsement, didn't Speaker Cayetano also didn't he also do that last year? Because I think he didn't have enough votes before the president intervened. So he also relied on the president's endorsement to get that post. So how come you're now saying that Congressman Velasco should not have just relied on the president's endorsement now?
So how can you say that he got no votes on starting July, on that July?
Last year.
On July 22. It's not true. Everybody is claiming that they have votes. Remember, lahat siya sila nagpalista ng manifesto sa different congressmen. And we did that as well. We have also numbers. And that will only be formalized when you have an actual vote on the plenary. Nobody can say that he got the monopoly of the votes of each and member of the House. As long as that you will be voted upon in the plenary, that's the time malalaman mo na may number ka.
So if Speaker Cayetano at that time had the votes already, why did he agree to this intervention by the president among the three candidates at that time?
Because he respected the president. He respected that the term sharing be put on the table. And that's a gentleman's agreement. They met, they have discussed, and they have agreed. And after that, Speaker Alan Cayetano consulted and reached out with the different members. We have spoken to the different party leaders. And even the members of the different parties were also consulted.
Okay.
Now, he gave his time to all of these members.
Okay.
And as a matter of fact, Christian, was what I'm saying a while ago, 15 months he worked so hard para mapagbigyan ng lahat to be transparent, to be fair, and to be equal to each and every members of the House of Representatives. And that's the reason why they voted in favor of rejecting the offer to resign.
How would you respond to this accusation coming from those who are supporting Congressman Velasco? That Congressman Velasco's fault was that he assumed that Speaker Cayetano was a gentleman and that he would keep his word.
He is a gentleman and he keeps his word. He resigned. As a matter of fact, never in his 15 months of being a speaker said that he will stay. Ang sinasabi po niya, if the president said na siya po ay mag-resign and ordered the agreement, he will honor the agreement. At nga, sinasabi nga po namin kanina, doon sa sinasabi po niya sa kanyang privilege speech, when he said that if the president tells him that he resigned as a congressman, he will also do. At yun ang ginawa po niya, Christian. He did that and he resigned.
So Speaker Cayetano, you're saying that he was sincere, that he really wanted to honor the agreement, because there are also impressions that he was somehow manufacturing certain justifications to keep himself in that position and to keep Congressman Velasco out of that deal.
No, Christian, we are close to Speaker Alan Cayetano, and we know exactly what he feels, you know. At sinasabi niya na hindi siya happy to call that he will stay in the speakership if the president will tell him that he will honor the term agreement. And precisely what happened, you know, nung sinabi sa kanya ng presidente that you honored the agreement last September 29, and they already agreeing on kailan i-implement yung resignation. And Lord Alan Velasco was insisting that it should be on September 30.
Okay.
Si Speaker Cayetano, after compelling with this family, agreed to resign yesterday.
So the Speaker was not manufacturing any reason or justification when in the past he claimed that at least on two occasions Congressman Velasco tried to orchestrate a coup against him.
Yeah, that's the reason why nagkaroon na nga ng ganitong parang nag-snowball na yung situation.
Pero hindi ba imbentong accusation lang yan na wala naman in the first place to justify?
No, it's not invento. No, it really happened that you have seen it in the budget hearing during the Department of Public Works and Highways. They wanted to really distract the deliberation of the budget. And they are insinuating that something is happening behind doors, which is not.
But was that reflective of a coup?
That's the reason why.
Mukha ba siyang coup?
Yes, yes, of course. They're doing something. Alam mo, Christian, there is something happening inside the Congress. Not only in the Congress, but also in the different Bible group of the different congressman. And you are not privy with this, but we are. And we can see the difference what's happening within those group.
Okay.
And of course,
can you tell us what was happening?
Well, I cannot divulge that anymore.
Okay, just to give us an idea.
The idea is that they're contemplating on trying to have their numbers to overthrow the speaker. And not only that, they wanted the speaker to look bad in the eyes of the president. And they're the one who are creating the problem in the budget deliberation. And they're now accusing the speaker, in delaying the budget by postponing the cancellation of the budget deliberation today. Do they really know what's the reason why we are canceling the deliberation of budget today?
Why?
Alam ba nila?
Why?
No, yun na nga eh. Why? You ask them. Alam ba nila? They don't know. Because they're not attending. They're not privy. Kasi nga, hindi sila nakikipag-participate. They're not joining. And we are doing this for the benefit of the parochial concern of the different congressmen. That's a problem with them eh. They're not trying to reach out with the leadership. That supposedly they have to, because he's the presumptive speaker.
Mm.
And the people have and the majority of the has already spoken.
But,
now if they wanted to change the leadership again, the speakership, they can do that anytime.
Mm-hmm.
They have all the rights to do that.
But by sheer operation of logic, why would someone who is already part of a term sharing deal engineer or orchestrate a coup against the sitting speaker, when in fact based on that agreement he is supposed to replace him?
Because he is so afraid that Speaker Alan Cayetano is being loved by the different branches of government. He is loved by the cabinet secretaries. He used to work with the Senate. He is a former congressman for 9 years in the House of Representatives. He got this working relationship with all the branches of government, and he can easily pass any measures and budget for that matter. And this capacity is not reflected on the personality of Congressman Alan Velasco. And that's the reason why he wanted to Speaker Alan Cayetano to look bad, by trying to stage a manipulated distraction, not only in the budget deliberation, but in everything that we do in Congress, not only in the deliberation of the different measures, but also in the anti-corruption that we are conducting the investigation.
Okay. I'm also wondering, Congressman, why you guys didn't raise these issues against Congressman Velasco as early as last year when the president brokered that deal?
Why should we? We want that. Ba't namin naman gagawin yun?
Hindi, parang ganito, di ba? So the president brokered the deal between Congressman Cayetano and Congressman Velasco. And you had concerns regarding, I assume, his competence. Tapos later on, you claimed that he was an absentee congressman.
No, Christian, he got his chance, For 15 months that we are working with the speaker, all the chairmanship, all the different chairman of the different committees, all the leaders of the House of Representatives. Remember, he's also a leader. He is the chairman of the Committee of Energy. He was given the opportunity to be the senior deputy speaker. Ang ibig sabihin, siya na po yung next in line with the speaker. Even the position is non-existent. Should have proven himself right away with us that he is the rightful successor of Speaker Alan Cayetano. But he blew his chance. Dapat primarily during that time that he's opening to be the next speaker, hindi pa namin kilala what kind of personality Lord Alan Velasco had. So dapat pinakita po niya yan sa ating pong mga members, and by doing it, be with us, work with us, we will be able to find out what kind of a leader he is.
Okay.
But unfortunately, he missed his point.
Okay. Finally, Congressman Fernandez, with the kind of support that Speaker Cayetano has now, do you think he could keep this post until 2022? And that what happened yesterday, can that be seen as an open defiance of the president's preference to uphold the term-sharing deal?
As long as he got a number, he can do that anytime. Actually, they can do that every day if they wanted to put the speakership, the vacancy of the speakership. Eh. But as long as they have the numbers. Yun ang sinasabi rin ng Presidente. And when Speaker Alan Cayetano have said that under the Constitution, it is still the majority of the House we will decide on the speakership, the President nodded in agreeing. No? Now, the next question that you were asking, I'm sorry, I forgot about the last question. No?
Can this be seen as an open defiance of the president's
no,
preference?
No, it's not an open defiance with the president. We respect the president. And as a matter of fact, the speaker already concluded that he will resign. At ginawa po niya yan. And this is not a defiance. Kanina nga, sinasabi ko sa iyo, Christian, that after agreeing with the term sharing, you know, during that time, you know, sa first sa opening ng 18th Congress, no, it's still the Congress who have decided for the fate of Speaker Alan Cayetano. If remember, Christian, nagkaroon din ng botohan doon sa opening ng aming 18th Congress.
Yeah.
And as a matter of fact, somebody contested also the position of speakership. And unfortunately, he lost, no? But he attempted. What I'm trying to say is that hindi po kami nag-defy sa sinasabi ni Presidente.
Okay.
Si Speaker Alan Cayetano adhere to the condition of the term sharing agreement.
Okay, Deputy Speaker Dan Fernandez, thank you very much for joining us this morning, sir.
Thank you.